this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate with the index expression.
Hey everyone, my name is Manuel.
Let's dive right in. I've already added a new shape to my comp. Now fill a 2-pixel wide stroke. And let's quickly reduce the size. Then let's open the rotation property, press R. The index expression refers to the index number of a layer. What does that mean? The layer index numbers are these numbers here, next to the layer name. We add an expression, hold Alt if you use a PC, Option if you use a Mac, while clicking on the stopwatch symbol. Then we type in the word index. And the rotation value is 1, like the index number. If we duplicate the layer a few times, open all rotation properties, you can see the rotation values equal the index numbers, which is pretty convenient. Let's say we want a lot of these shapes positioned along the horizontal center. We open the position property, press P, and separate the dimensions. We only want to change the X position. Let's add an expression to the property and add index again. The value is 1, like the index number. If we multiply this value by 200, the value turns into 200. 1 multiplied by 200 is 200. If we duplicate the shape moves 200 pixels to the right with each new layer, starting at 200 pixels. What if we want to start with 0 pixels? We subtract 1 from the index value in parentheses because of the multiplication before subtraction rule. And voila, 0. But what if we want to change the distance? That means deleting all the layers and changing the value. That's when expression controls come into play. We add a null object to add the expression control. Name it controls. And add a slider control. We go to Effect, Expression Controls, Slider Control. Let's name it Distance. And let's change the range. Right-click on the property, edit value, and let's set the 2 value to 500. That should be enough. And by the way, the index numbers of the layers changed because of the new controls layer. If you still want to start with 0, change the expression into index minus 2, back to 0. If you lock this view here, the expression control will remain visible even when you select a different layer. Then let's select the value, 200, and use the expression pick whip to replace it with a link to the slider control. We duplicate the layer a few times, nothing happens because the distance is 0. We adjust that, and just like that, you can quickly position the shapes. Let's animate the shapes, the Y position. We add an expression to it and add wiggle and 2,200 in parentheses. 2 times per second, the Y value animates max 200 pixels in both directions. From the start point, 540 pixels. Let's duplicate the layer a few times and all seems great. But to make sure all the shapes have a different animation pattern, and even more important, have the same animation pattern assigned each time you play it, we need to assign a seed number with the seed random expression. Let's delete the layers again. Before the wiggle expression, we add seed random, capital R, and instead of adding a seed number, we refer to the index number of the layer, index, semicolon at the end. We automatically assign a different seed number to each wiggle expression. Let's duplicate the layers again. Imagine you would have to animate all that with keyframes. So simple expressions can just like that speed up your workflow a lot. You can create a particles rig, for example. Once set up, you can use it again and again. Impossible with keyframes. Or create responsive animations that automatically adjust to your comp size. I know this is overwhelming at the beginning. That's why in my new course, we start from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. More than 50-page-long expression sheet will accompany you. Plus, I add new bonus content every month. You will create animations that wouldn't be possible without expressions. Learn how to animate with expressions and After Effects. Link is in the description. Finally, let's create something crazy. We add a new shape, double-click on the rectangle tool. Then open the rectangle one-path property and reduce the shape size to 30 by 500 pixels. Then, inside the rectangle path property, we move the position to Y 250 pixels, so that the anchor point of the shape is at the top. Next, we open the rotation property, press R, and add an expression. Index multiplied by 10. Each time we duplicate the layer, the rotation increases by 10 degrees. Then we animate the scale. We hold Shift while pressing S to open the property. We want to animate the length of the shape, meaning the Y value. Therefore, we add an expression and add the seed random expression first. Seed random and index in parentheses, semicolon. As the scale value is two-dimensional, we define a variable for each dimension. Var x equals, we link to the x value of the property. We want to keep that value, semicolon. Var y equals wiggle and 2,100 in parentheses. To apply the wiggle expression only to the y value, we add square brackets and 1 inside. The x value has the index number 0. The expression refers to the y value. The y value has the index number 1. Semicolon. We add an array, x, y, the two variables inside. And finally, we want to change the color. We add the change color effect. You can find it in color correction. Change color. We add an expression to the hue transform property and add index multiplied by 5. Finally, we duplicate the layer 36 times. The index expression helps you to manage repetitive tasks quickly and speeds up your workflow a lot. Awesome. To learn more about expressions, check out my course. Link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.